There we go. Be right with you guys. We are gonna paint a painting. I'm only gonna use blue, yellow, red, white, and black. That's my palette. 5 colors. So, I think I'm just gonna rock out and paint a painting with 5 colors. So, welcome. Oh, let's see. Let's go ahead and get started. I'm just gonna pull a little blue off the side here. Wisp in the sky. Dark in the corners. Staining the canvas. Like I said, I just got a blue, yellow, red, black, and white. So, let's see what we can make. Fluff this a little bit. Get a good conditioning of color into this canvas. Yeah. Sorry. Yo, what's up? Kind of doing a little practice and went to a bigger size canvas. So I know I can do an 8x10 and 20. I didn't really set a timer tonight, but it's 11x14. Oh, I think I can rock one out in about 20 minutes. But more so, I just want to have fun and paint today. I'm okay. Enjoyable piece. How are you guys doing tonight? Things going okay for everyone? Having a good Friday night? Put some clouds back in the back. Rubbing color in. There we go. I'm gonna do a seascape. Maybe. An island scene. Colors. Grab some blue, some alizarin crimson, a little bit of black, a touch of green, or yellow. Okay. I want to dark color, but we're going to make it kind of based in green. Just mix this up real quick. Back island. Punch in a little inlet island green here. Goes off in the distance. So use all that dark color up. Maybe even add a little more black. We're going to come in with some highlights, but. Reflection real quick. Real quick, gonna clean the brush, get a little more yellow, maybe doing some alizarin crimson, kind of make it orange, green, we'll see, a little bit of everything here. Just need a little paint thinner, then the base, and we're just gonna pop some color. Somewhere here, square, we have a little horizon line. So I'm just going to grab some of my white. I'm going to scratch in an idea. Good. I don't know what I'm painting, but I'm just painting and pushing myself. Okay. You know what I think I'm going to do? We're going to bring this forward. So, I'm going to grab on my palette knife some of that blue, a little black, some alizarin crimson, a little yellow. We're going to mix up color again real quick. Again, I only am using five colors, blue, yellow, red, black, and white. And I'm making this painting up as I go. So, a little more of that blue in there. Yeah. There we go, get it good and mixed up. I'm going to use a brush I don't normally use, which is a foliage brush. So I'm just going to load up real quick, and we're going to just pop dark color in here. Punch it in, and use up almost all my colors. I can add more again. It's okay, but I just wanted to stick to five root colors. But punching that in. Okay, I heard your message. Sorry. I was just jamming tonight. You know, my goal wasn't really to worry about too much lives or, you know, people in live. I just wanted to jam tonight. Paint, beanie. But yeah, I'll turn it down just to be polite. My apologies. Alright. Green, yellow. I'm just gonna punch in, lay that's Jamie. But this one's just a quick painting. We'll see what I'm going to do. I'm going to toss in actually a big old palm tree here, actually. So I'm just reloading my palette. I need some more yellow. I need a little more blue and a little more red. But I'm only using five colors, like I said. Ivory black, alizarin crimson, phthalo blue, and tad yellow. Where did my blue go? There it is. Okay, and then titanium white. That's the other color. Well, thank you, Jamie. I appreciate it. That's kind of some of my thought processes. I don't know what's in my head. Good song, good film. Alright, I'm going to go in with a little yellow, some paint thinner. I'm just going to smack a little bit of brighter edge here. We'll come in and we'll make it fun here in a second, but just need to get to that. Got lip of the inlet here taken care of. A little white, some more cad yellow, punch in, and some weird grass thingies. That's what's awesome about this little foliage brush. You just turn it, it makes a different thing every time. It's very awesome. So, anyway, let's rock out. I'm gonna go with some alizarin crimson, some black over here. A lot more black. I'll pull some blue. Okay. What we're gonna do real quick is right there, popping in a big old palm tree. Just like that. Okay. Down, form our trunk. Okay. Okay. Real quick, just fill it with paint. Now we're gonna have a dark side. Highlights here, so really cake this on where we want our highlights to show. I'm going to grab a little bit of white, almost make a violet purple color. Okay. And oh, we'll just pull a little bit of color down. This may be hard for you guys to see, but when I show the close-up, you'll catch it. Okay. Just want a little bit of a highlight on the side of that tree. Before we get too crazy and add them palms, just want to make sure everything's golden and good. Just like that. Boop. Alright. Oh, hey, thank you. Thank you guys for the follows and likes. Okay. Now then, we're going to do some palms. I'm going to go in with my black over here, and some blue. Black and blue, a little paint thinner, but I'm going to punch in the idea of a palm leaf, okay. Just like that, curve it around, we'll make the idea of one here. When you pull down, you're getting that dark shadow. And when we go do highlights, boy, that'll look fun. It'll look great. So, again, just mixing this paint. Sticking in fan brush, some palms. Just add to this tree. Making an old weathered tree. It's been around. You notice it's the only palm tree? It's the one that survived in the storm, I think.
Okay.
Now then, we are going to go ahead. Well, thank you.
Thank you, guys. So I'm going to clean this brush off real quick.
And then I'm going to go into this yellow right away. And maybe even pull some white. Yep. We'll just pull some white. And put in some highlights, just like that. Okay. Like that. Brighten it up a little bit with some more white. Just real quick, throw some palm leaves in. Palms. I don't know what we call palm leaves. Palm branches. Anyway, like that. Get it real quick. Palm. Pull like that. Alright, now then. So I've got some paint left over, and what I think I'm going to do, this painting's pretty much done. Just going to blend out spots here. Make those clouds really fluff. Okay. And then we'll go across the water here shortly. We'll get our horizon line in. And paint some dark on this side to blend in with this side. We'll cut in our lines here shortly. But I got, some blue left over. Okay, I'm just going to use up all whatever I have on my palette. Yellow, red, and blue. That's what we started with. That's what I want to kind of take this painting towards. All those colors blended together. I need to get darker, I think, here on the front. I don't know how this song ended up on here. Yeah, Dave, I just cut mine out, actually, out of a piece of plastic and carved what I thought would work, and it does work. I use both sides, wipe it off clean. It started as clear, but now, just punch it in, dark color here. I'm going to do my highlights. But yeah, it's just a piece of plastic. About yay thick. I mean, it's not really that thick. I would never in my life actually sing this song. I wasn't embarrassing myself on live right now. Soap up all this leftover color. Just gonna punch in. See, I just punch in some color, dark versus light, light versus dark. Okay. Now then. I don't know if the stain on the wood one would. No, as long as you clean it properly. My problem is I just don't take the time to clean my palette. I clean my brushes and everything, but it's never my palette. Okay, I'm adding yellow because I ran out. And we're just going to punch in ideas, some grass, some growth. Palm trees growing in between a whole bunch of everything. Just using the fan brush sideways, kind of punching it in. Punch it upright, too. Any little witch angle. Fan brush is actually a really great brush. It's underutilized, I think, by a lot of people. So, I'm gonna do the same thing here. Highlight one side. wholesome color. I don't know what kind of plant this is, but light versus dark, dark versus light. Just play with it real quick. White. We're gonna cut in a horizon line, scrape in some water movement. I scraped my knife too much by my tree there.
Dang it.
It's okay. Let's blend it out. That with a palette knife if I want. Anyway, let's get a line there. Get it there. Okay. Kind of digging the painting. Fix my make those sound effects, and I'm gonna go ahead and just with the knife, I'm gonna scratch out. Stalks and things here. Yep, alright. Well, I think, pretty much, it's a fun,
fast and furious
palm scene. And just a little more highlight. Some white and green here left over on my dirty palette. So, let's make it punch a little bit. Okay. Do touch-ups where you need. Just playing to see what I can come up with, but... Anyway, oh shit, wrong move, buddy. Alright, there we go. If I keep playing with this, I'll fiddle it all up. No, I don't want to do that, so. Other than that, it's a quick and easy paint. Yep. Red to yellow, blue, black, and white. That's all I used. Alright guys, I'll go ahead and give you a little bit of a closer look. Hello there. Taller than I expected. I just thought I'd hop on and do a painting using five colors, red, yellow, blue, black, and white. Kind of mix my own tones and play with it and see what I could do. So, what do you guys think? I'm not sure when I started. I think it's probably about a half hour painting at this point, maybe. But, yeah.
Well, thank you, Dave. I appreciate that. So yeah, if I had more time, I would definitely darken and muddle this up and maybe add, you know, just to add a little bit to it. And also my canvas popped up while I was trying to paint it. So that was rough. Kind of a fun thing to do is that when I clean up my palette, I'll put some paint thinner on a brush and just go into all the colors I have left over and try to incorporate that dark color into the painting. Nice and thin little spots, just things that make it look different. Yeah, I'm a cheap artist, so I like to use up all my paint. Alright, my friends. Well, I think I'm going to center the camera and do the old thank you for your support. Thank you for the views. Thank you for the likes, the shares, the comments. Any tips that came in, I really apologize if I missed them, but they are appreciated. Also, you'll notice during our flight, the in-flight movie is something from 1984. We've had to cut some costs, so bear with us if you find it inappropriate for all ages. The exits are pretty much wherever you want to have them. I would highly suggest using one through a door, not a wall. But again, we thank you for your continued support on Flying with Mick. I don't know what I was doing there. I was just having fun. Yeah. But yeah. Alright, my friends. Well, like every painting, I end up with dirty fingers and dirty hands, so I need to go wash them. But, there was a fun, quick little painting that I did, and I hope you all enjoyed. Have a wonderful night, a safe weekend, enjoy the Super Bowl, and be well, my friends. Night.